group. Thank you for taking your time to come and join this meetup, and hopefully we can share and learn some things, because all these things that are being presented today actually was shared to me by some other people also. So hopefully you can get some things interesting that can help to bring up our level of competency in developing software. Okay, so I will start with Vue.js first. So Vue.js is one of the front-end frameworks similar to Angular.js, React.js, Ember. I think this one you all know. What they write in the website for Vue.js is that it's a simple yet powerful library for building modern web interfaces, blah. Okay, so actually what it really is like is looking at the code, it looks very much like React.js, where they have components, they have props and states. But it's just that there's no JSX inside. Vue.js still has a HTML and CSS outside, but I think React mainly, the HTML and the CSS are all inside the JSX. Okay, so contrary to popular belief or what they write inside that Vue.js is actually easy to learn. Yes, it is easy to learn, but both of them, once you progress, there's actually a learning curve to master the both of them, especially when you get to the part where there's the routers and the state management. Okay, for those of you who come from React.js, there's this thing called Flux and Redux, right? Yeah, so it's the same. Once you get used to it, it's okay, but there's a learning curve. So Vue is actually not easy. It's starting, yes, easy, hello, easy, but after that, it starts to get more difficult. Yes. So there is a guide to compare the two. You all can take a look at it. It's just to read only. One interesting part also that you see inside the Vue.js is that I see quite a lot of search results in Google where they actually use Laravel, which is a PHP framework. Lumen is based on Laravel. That they do microservices. They use this with Vue together. So a lot of example codes are using this so far from what I see. So now I'll proceed to the important projects in Vue.js. Yeah, please, you can take a seat in front. It's okay, because the words may be a bit small, especially when you come to the code. Okay, so these are the four important ones. Basically, it's Vue.js itself. Then they have a Vue resource. This Vue resource is actually a HTTP client for Vue.js, and they got promises and more. You can actually not use this one and use things like Axios or even jQuery. Okay, so the next one that's an important thing to use in Vue is the Vue router. So this is the official router for Vue.js. And finally, this Vuex. So it's a centralized state management. It's like the React.js Flux and Redux. Okay, so things to note. Version 2 was released in October 2016. So we'll be using all the examples based on version 2. There's actually many breaking changes. So actually I prepared something about 1 month plus ago. All didn't work, had to redo from scratch. Quite a few things. Okay, from version 1 to version 2, it's important to use the migration guide, because one thing you need to use the migration guide, because all the examples, a lot of examples now are based on version 1. Okay, so this migration guide is very important so that you can make the code work again. There's two migration guides, one for Vue.js itself and one for the Vue router. It's not that difficult to migrate after you get the hang of it. Vuex does not require migration for now. And there's this migration helper. This Vue migration helper is actually a Node.js application where you can run, and then it will check all the deprecated functions and tell you what to do. It's quite helpful. Most of the code samples may now have ES6. Anybody don't know what is ES6. Okay, ES6 is actually is JavaScript, but there's a new functions, a new synthetic syntax and so on. Most of the code are starting to appear to have ES6, so it's good to start learning this, whether through self-study or through this sort of meetups. And because within 1-2 years, it may be that you read the JavaScript code, you won't understand because of this ES6 thing. The functions, a lot of things look very different. Okay, so today, what will we be going through? The basics. Okay, this one, a lot from the website, the Vue.js website. Then the migration of an application from V1 to V2. This one is not so basic. It's a single page CRUD application. Later I'll give you the link to download the source from GitHub. Yes, and then the last one is to look at the same application, one written in React.js and one in Vue.js, just to get a feel of what it looks like. Okay, so now we come to the basics. We'll go through all these six things right now. Declarative rendering. Okay. Ooh. Why doesn't the... Oh, I know why. Okay. So, we are gonna start on the declarative part. Let me do a F5. Okay, so you see this Hello Vue.js. This actually is this message here. This message here, and where it actually appears is that there's this thing called data down here. So this is the Hello Vue.js. Okay, so this is where you declare and render the thing. Okay, so if let's say I were to do this app, because this ID is app, message equals to ABCD. Okay, the thing actually changes to ABCD, so it's reactive. So next we take a look at another thing, which is the binding also. You can bind the message to this this thing called title. So what happens is that, okay, see this title over here, once you hover over it, the message will appear. So if the message is different, okay, when you hover over it, the change is also there reflected. Okay. So we next move on to input bindings. So we'll have an input. This is actually the easy part. The hard part is the later on. Okay, so this is the input. So you have an input down here. So once you change, actually all these things all change. Okay. You change all these things, you hover. It will all change. Okay, I can follow. Okay, next we have a computed properties. Okay, so this computed properties, now we'll go back down again. Okay, you take note of this thing called reverse message. Okay, this is a computed property where you have this key computed. And then this reverse message, this function, they will reverse the message. So what happens is that this is the result. Okay, so if you do any changes, it will also reflect. So this is the computed changes, computed properties. Okay, next, binding to styles. So this, there's this bind here to the style where you can actually have the color and the font size all down here. We can change and then it will reflect. But what I show you, what will happen is that, so this is the result. So pretty basic stuff. Okay, now I'll move to conditionals. So we actually have an input down here. Okay, this is the app number 2. This one. Okay, this scene is the true or false with this checkbox here. So currently set to true. And what will happen is that this scene is also with this span and a V if, and this one will be affected by the input down here. Okay, so that's for the conditionals. Am I going too fast? Sorry?
Yeah, it's okay.
Okay, thank you. Okay, so next. So this is actually still programming 101 area. Next, they have the list, the looping. So what happens is that there's this this list of to-dos, which is actually down here. It's inside the data. So what happened is that there's a V4 which will loop through and display all the data. Okay, for tables it's a slightly different issue. You have to read inside the Vue.js how to loop through the tables, because there's something else to use to get the thing working in tables. This one, maybe after this, if you are not sure, I can go through it with you. Okay, so the last one is, event handling. So actually we did some event handling just now, but we're gonna do some here again, which if you click, what will happen is that it will push a new item into this to do, and then you see the list growing. So I think one of them is not working. This one is not working. I have to find out why, because it was version 1 and version 2 thing, I think. I need to confirm it, but the other one is working. So as I click on the button, you can see the thing growing. Yeah, that's why I have two buttons, add buttons here, because one of them actually is supposed to work, because we call this a app, because it's a declared here, app2, and then you dot the these to-dos because it's inside app2 also. You should actually be able to work on it, but somehow it didn't work. So that's why it's an exercise for anybody who's interested to try and get it working. Okay, so that's all for the basic. For the basic one. So now we go to the intermediate. Okay, so for this intermediate one, I am actually migrated that application from version 1 to version 2. The version 1 application was from CodePen originally. What happened was that this V-link is actually related to the router. It's changed from V-link to router link. So all the old codes that are using V-link all have to rewrite. And then there's this function called router map. It was removed, and the way they initialize the router is a different way. So all the old codes, again, broken, have to remove. The templates for each of the views, now they must have a root node. So because previously the template, they have many nodes they don't have the root node, so now need to have a root node. Then some other functions are deprecated. So this one, I'll just give you a quick run through. The source code, if you want, is actually here. Okay, so yeah, that's actually the more important thing. Okay, so I'll go through the code now.
When you talk about the templates, are you talking about the modules that you've created, app and app 2?
No, this one is different already. This one is this is the template which I'll be talking about. This is the more just now was 101. This one is 10.01.
Yeah. So in the previous example, when you talked about the different modules, you have an app module and an app 2 module, and that's what you used in the page.
Yes, correct.
Use them effectively, you put them in the div name, so div name is specified as app, and that's how it works?
In a simple case, yes. But once you build bigger applications, it's like React, you have to plan out the big one, and then you go to the smaller components within the big one.
Okay.
Yes, so maybe I will give an overview of the structure.
Sure.
Okay, this is a CRUD application. Oh, sorry. Okay. So this whole thing is the app. The whole thing is the app. Okay, there's a list of products. Okay, is component is this whole thing down here, where they have a add product button, a search, and a list of the product. So this is one of the component. Then when they go to add product, this is another component. So the other one is when they go to edit, it is also another component. And then the delete also is another component. And this other one is also one component. So I will show you the components now. Okay, so you have one template called product. So this one actually refers to this one here. Okay. Then you have a product list. This is the bigger one. Okay, so this refers to this whole part here. Yeah, and then I think the edit is one component here, and delete is here, and the add is here. Okay, so there's five of these templates altogether. Okay, so this is not connecting to a real database. I just have some data here for test. Okay. So what happens is when they said that there has to be a root node, previously this div was not here in the code, so cannot run. So we have to add. This is the simple part. The other thing is the router. There's no more router.map. What happens is that you just do the router and then you initialize the roots like this, passing in information. Most of the, after I passed it in, the thing still worked. Fortunately, they didn't change any of the things down here from the original code. Then router link, yes, router link is found in the template down here. Okay, this router link thing, the vlink changed to router link, and so there's quite a few things to change, like this tool and the path and so on. So breaking changes. Then what was the next thing that template must have root node get. This one I will skip because there's actually too many. I'll go through more on the structure. Okay, so this product list, basically this is the add button. Then you have the router link, which goes to the path to add button. You have these filters down here. Okay, this filter, where's the input? You can actually input, and it will actually filter the text. Okay, let me create a new product first, Okay, so what happens, the filter is that if you type, it will filter. Okay, or EM, it will actually filter this filter. And where they do the filter is actually inside the inside here, filtered products. This is a computed function. Do the filtered products. Previously, they actually pipe in this filter. There's actually a pipe down here with a filter by this thing in order to do the filtering. But they deprecated the thing, and now you have to put this thing into a computed So that's another breaking change. Okay, so basically the function, that's the filter, then the add, you have seen edit. Okay, if they edit, no error checking, but you can see that there's actually the changes are done. The delete also is basically is there. Yeah, so the CRUD all in a single page, you can actually extend it further. You can download this and use it to extend it further. Yeah, so I think maybe that's all for this. Okay, finally, the last one, React.js and a Vue side by side. So this is actually from this Feathers.js. Feathers.js is another of one of those Node.js frameworks, like Happy and Sales.js. This is the HTML part, but from here on, this one will all be React. So a lot of JavaScript and all the HTML and CSS is all inside the JSX. Okay, for the Vue.js is different, exactly the same, but they have this template, and then they have the script with all the things inside. So they're actually quite different because of that JSX thing. What's the comparison? Okay, the script size, the Vue is 4 KB HTML, 4 KB JS. The React is 1 KB HTML, most of it is in JSX. The components, exactly the same. The whole app, the user list, message list, and compose message. So this is from another the Feathers.js example. The Vue.js example for that one is still in version 1. So right now I'm actually trying to convert it to version 2. Yeah. So for JSX, everything is inside the React. And then I think the last one, this website is quite good. There's quite a lot of things to learn inside, coligo.io. Yeah, to get started, actually the best place is still Vue.js website because the code is all version 2 already. And so yeah, I guess that's the end. I will, any questions can ask later. The next person will come and present Azure for deployment, production deployment. Gerald from Microsoft. Okay.